Hello guys on YouTube, how are you guys doing today? Well, today I am doing a bit more of testing with different style of antennas for my old analog Toshiba stereo receiver to see what I can actually use. Now, I tried all sorts of different style of antennas before, and they don't really work that good. They all seem to suck of getting a good signal for this old analog receiver. Now, by the way, I do live in a brick house, and that's the biggest problem with the signal strength of my antennas and the signal strength of the radio. It's trying to get a good signal for the radio itself. Now, you can use whatever antenna you choose to use for your radio. Like, you can use copper wire, solid copper, stranded copper. It only depends on what you want to try to use for this type of radio and see if you guys can get a very good signal strength. Now, these are only indoor antennas. I do not have any outdoor antennas at all. That would actually be the best thing to use. Now, the one thing I did a long time ago is I actually made the antenna, and I just stuck the antenna right onto my window for it to be pointing outside so it can get a little bit better signal strength. Now, if you want, you can go ahead and start drilling some holes in your wall to feed the wire shoe for your radio yourself. Now, the biggest problem, the biggest disadvantage with this style radio, it doesn't have any type of Colex connectors to actually connect a Colex TV cable directly to the back of your receiver. Now, again, you have to do some more modifications to your radio if you want to do that. That's up to you. I actually done a modification to this radio, and I put a BCN connector on the back of it, so I can use a BCN style type of cable. So I can use that cable as my antenna wire, and I very like it a whole lot. Everything seems to work very good with the way I have everything made and put together. Now, you guys notice this is my whole tile setup, and this is my whole tile of my whole equipment, and everything seems to work pretty darn good with it. Now, typically in the olden days, you won't typically have all of this stuff, but yes, I love old school technology, and I do love the newer technology, and that's how everything gets controlled by that one top piece is the main system at all of this whole unit. Now, I'm going to tell you guys, the biggest problem with using analog is you literally have to get up and actually tune the stations in yourself, tune the system on yourself. It doesn't come with any type of remotes or anything like that to actually switch back and forth to whatever different units you actually have plugged into it. That's the biggest disadvantage of having old school technology, but it still seems to work. Now, I'm using amplifiers and filters for the antenna to see what actually seems to work the best with this machine, and I really enjoy having this old unit. I really do, guys. I enjoy having everything with this old unit. It really works. No issues with it yet. But you guys notice this is a very old style. You guys can see it has all the knobs and everything. You have to actually manually do this yourself. You literally don't have push buttons. Except for a couple push buttons here, you can push these in and turn these on. Now, if you guys notice, we do have some needles on here for the signal strength and the little light there for the FM station. That's what I typically use versus the AM station, because again, I do not have an AM antenna to being hooked up to this radio yet, because I really don't get any AM stations I like to listen to or anything like that with this unit. Now, let's go over to this antenna we have right here. This is a Philips antenna. This is meant for your TVs, but it actually seems to work with this older radio right here, and we do have some own stuff like this amplifier. This amplifier is a cable amplifier I can probably use for this setup. It seems to work pretty good. I actually did try it out, and it seems to work very nicely with this system as well. Now, we go on the back of my radio right here. Now, on the back of this older style radio, you guys notice we have a couple of screw terminals on the back. That's where you normally will screw your antenna wires, like your FM or your AM antennas. Now, here's this little adapter I had years ago for this radio. Now, this is typically meant actual for TVs, for old school televisions, and you didn't even have actual cable on your old school TVs. That's what this was, and you guys can see I have a filter, and I actually have a cable right here that's coming off of this antenna here. This is my antenna cable. This is a Colex cable going in, filters, and goes into the radio itself to give me a little bit signal. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but you know, if I move around a little bit, you guys can see the light is starting to flash and blink. But the only thing you can do with that, if you want, is to try to tune it in. And you can tune it in nicely as well. And that's typically what's okay about this older unit, is sometimes you will actually have to tune this whole system in by hand. It's kind of annoying, but that's just the way this analog works, so you guys can see. I do have a couple of digital devices. DVD player, CD player, tape player, you know, that kind of stuff, but everything seems to work very nicely on this unit. I really enjoy it. Now, we do have it on the FM band only. We're going to turn it up just a smidge here for you guys can actually take a listen to see what it actually sounds like with the FM radio and using this contraption of an antenna, a filter, and that adapter on the back of my receiver. But I don't like using that because it would put a lot of strain on the wire that would actually eventually break over time. Let's go and turn this up a little bit. But it's still a little staticky because that's typically a normal with any style radio. Definitely if you put them inside the house. But if you want to use a outdoor antenna, that might work a little bit better for you guys. If you want to do that, but you do have to do a little bit more drilling and setting up all the cables and stuff like that for your older pieces of equipment. Now, why is this thing so old? Because that's just the way it was made in the late 60s or the late 70s. That's just the way this was made. I don't know when it actually came out, but it's a very nice unit. And everything seems to work just fine the way I actually have it all set up. By the way, this is my main unit. This controls mostly all everything, if that everything breaks, but I hope to God no, it does. But you never know. I don't have to replace it anytime soon, but the antennas seem to work pretty good. You can try any antenna you want to use. Like I said, you can use indoor or outdoor antennas, or even copper wire if you choose to use that kind of stuff for your radios as well. Now, how does this all work? You guys are wondering. How does this all work? Now, this is called radioids, okay? You guys can see right here. This is called radioids right here, okay? The radioids are in the air, and that's how the radio actually picks up the signal and gives you actual sound and listening to your music on your receiver. Now, first of all, you do have to have an antenna hooked up to your radio itself to make sure you do get that strength and that signal. And you can connect it this way if you want. You can use the Colex connector, you can connect it here, you can connect it in the filter, you can connect it on the back of your radio itself. But problem is, this old radio doesn't have that capability. That's why you have to use this adapter to be able to adapt it to a Colex connector, but I modded it with a BCN connector, and that seems to work out pretty good. But you can choose to use whatever you want to use with your equipment. It's your equipment. You can do whatever you want to see what antennas will actually work the best for you guys. But this is just my little testing rig and modifications. Alright guys, if you are brand new to this channel, please hit that subscribe button, leave a comment down below. Please like, bye, see you guys later. Thank you for watching today's vlog. Alright, later guys.